everyone, and welcome to my new doll repaint video. Today I'm going to continue working on my Disney Princess doll collection, and after making a couple of, you know, old-fashioned classics, like I've made already two Cinderellas, I've made a Snow White doll, and I've made already Jasmine doll. Jasmine is of course a little bit more modern, she's from the 90s, it's a princess from my childhood, but anyway, it's also already vintage, so today I'm going to go a little bit more modern direction, and as you could see it already from the thumbnail, today we're going to make a Merida doll. And as a model for this transformation, I've decided to take this Frankie doll. I think she looks a little bit like Merida because of this more round face shape. Anyway, even if she doesn't look like Merida right now, I'm going to help her in the future. And I'm going to start right now, like always, with removing her outfit, removing her shoes and the accessories. And then I'm going to cut her hair as short as I can. Then I will need my hair dryer to make the head soft to be able to disconnect it from the body without breaking the doll. And it will also melt the glue that is still holding the rest of the hair inside. And then I will take my old tweezers and I will remove the rest of the hair together with this glue from the inside of the head. Now let's take pure acetone, some cotton pads and Q-tips and remove her original makeup. I'm going to re-root her hair and I think I have found an absolutely ideal hair color for my future Merida. Look, it's even called Celtic Red, and Merida is a girl from Scotland and it means she's Celtic. So it's an absolutely perfect match, I think. And now I'm going to cover her head with a couple of layers of red acrylics, and after this I will re-root her head using this hair. So, and here is her hair after a couple of hours of working. Now I will add tacky glue to the inside of her head, I will spread it there nicely with Q-tips, and then I will let it dry for at least 24 hours. When the glue gets completely dry, I protect her hair, because the next step is applying a couple of layers of acrylic to the face and to the body. After the acrylics got dried, I sprayed the doll also with a couple of layers of Mr. Super Clear sealant to make the surface matte, and now I can finally start drawing her face. And I begin like always with her eyes and with the eyebrows. Then I'm going to blush her face using soft pastels. I protect all these layers of pastels with the sealant and then I draw her face in color. First of all, I draw the white of her eyes, the waterline and the eyelids. And she will have, of course, blue eyes, the same like in the cartoon. I make the eyebrows more realistic looking and then I start working on her lips. This layer I'm going to repeat twice to get the very best coverage out of the pencils. And after this I'm going to draw the shadows and the highlights to make this face more alive. Now I can draw the bottom eyelashes and the upper false lashes I'm going to attach a little bit later when the hair is done because it's easy to damage these lashes and they're not heat resistant, so this step I'm doing at the very end. Now let's also blush her body and after this I'm going to add freckles. To make the freckles, I mix together a couple of shades of acrylics, then I dilute them with water to get quite a liquid texture, and then I spray on the freckles using a hard synthetic brush. And all the messy spots I clean up with Q-tips. I still need to add reflections to her eyes using white acrylics and now her face is done and we can start styling her hair because it's going to take a very long time today. Merida has obviously curly hair and I can tell you honestly it's really difficult to make these kind of curls on dolls. Look, even if I take this really smallest, finest, thinnest hair curler on the market, it's probably 9 mm thin here. It's not going to give us these beautiful spiral, very tight curls. With this curler you can make pretty locks or some, you know, beach waves, something like this. Hot wash is going to make just some bloody mess out of it, because really, this kind of hair, this kind of curls requires a really very precise handwork. So I'm going to use one very long but very effective method. I'm going to take your hair really strand per strand, millimeter per millimeter, turn it around the barbecue stick and warm it up with a hair straightener. And just like this, we will get the perfect and ideal Merida curls. So and here we are, it took me exactly 3 hours to make these curls, guys, but now they're just ideal. I just want to cut off these messy ends and then I will finally attach the lashes and add glossy varnish to her eyes and lips. Now it's time to make her outfit and the accessories, and my mom was responsible today for the Merida's dress. And she has obviously tried to recreate the one we can see in the original Disney cartoon. Here is the finished dress. It looks really gorgeous. This velvet is very soft and the details are amazing. So now I need to make a bow, a quiver and a set of arrows for my doll. The bow I'm going to make using my epoxy sculpt, and first of all I'm sketching the shape of it on paper and then I put a piece of tape on it. Like this the epoxy will not stick to the paper surface and I would be able easily to remove it when it's dry. So and then I'm actually sculpting it. After this, I cover it with acrylics. And then I add some details using gold acrylics. I don't know, I don't think my bow is wow enough yet, so I want to add some extra decoration to it. At the same time, together with the bow, I'm making the quiver, and for this I'm going to use a piece of this warbler material. It gets very soft when you warm it up with a hairdryer or with a heat gun. Then you can modify it and just sculpt just whatever you want out of it. And then it gets hard as a real plastic again. I think it's an amazing material and it's just ideal to make the quiver and the belt today. The belt I'm going to make around her dress to be sure it fits good, but first I need to protect the fabric, of course. I attach pieces of Velcro to the ends of the belt and then I cover it with dark brown acrylics. Using this dots tool for nail art design, I decorate the quiver and the belt with golden acrylics. And then I also add a couple of rhinestones to finish it up. now let's make a couple of arrows out of these toothpicks. I'm going to take a stripe of paper and attach a piece of double-sided tape to the back of it. Then I cut off one side of the toothpicks and I attach there the piece of paper with tape. I shape it a little bit, cover it with acrylics, and here we go! So now let's put it all together and then we'll take a look at the end result pictures. I use, by the way, two different methods to attach objects to my doll hands. It can be a piece of double-sided tape or this kind of elastics. And today I'm going to use elastics. So, and here is my princess Merida. I'm a huge fan of her huge hair, but it's of course easy to explain because making these curls took me as long as rerooting the hair, so it's pretty normal. But I also adore the tiny quiver with the rhinestones and the bow and the dress. It's like always, doesn't matter. But anyway, I should make more things out of this warbler material. This is my just second experience with it. The first one was the slippers for Billie Eilish doll, and both of the times the end result looks just amazing. So, now let's decide who is going to be our next Disney princess to make. Or maybe should we make a villain for once? I don't know, please write me your ideas and suggestions in the comments here down below. And this doll will be available for 3 days on eBay, so if you wanted to get one of my dolls, the link will be in the description box. That was my doll transformation of the week. I really hope you enjoyed it today, guys. And if so, please don't forget to support my art here on YouTube with your likes. Of course, subscribe to my channel if you're new here. I upload new doll repaint videos every week Friday already for almost 3 years. So click that subscribe button, click the bell button, and I will see you already very, very, very soon. Next week Friday, we are going to try something completely new. Love you guys. Bye.